We'll continue with the problems on butterfly spread. Okay, so we'll do a question paper problem that is from the paper June-July 2011. They have given us the options, the table I will write down for you. So they are asking you to do a butterfly spread. I have not written the entire question, I have just written what is given. They have given the detailed table where they know the three options, what are the exercise prices and the premium. And they have told you that these are the expected market prices. So using these prices, we have to find whether there is gain or loss in the butterfly spread. Now first thing, when we start with the butterfly spread problem, I told you we have to check on whether the mid strike price is the average of the upper and the lower price or no. So the mid exercise price 75 should be the average of the higher and the lower price. So higher price is 90 plus lower price is 60. 90 plus 60 is 150 divided by 2. If you do, you get the average, that is 75, and that is the mid strike price. So the problem is correct and we can draw it, solve it further. Now they have not told you which strategy to adopt, whether you should go for buy at lower and sell at higher and or center price. So we will decide which strategy to adopt. When they don't give, you have the choice to decide. So here, let's buy at E1. This is a call option. And if so, I'm buying one at the low price, buying one at the high price, and buying two, selling two at the center price or the mid strike price. Now, if I buy, I have to pay premium. So I've bought here at 60. I'll pay premium 7 rupees. I have sold two here, so I'll receive premium. So 2 × 5, 10 rupees I will receive. I have again bought this, so I will pay 4 rupees. So minus 7 minus 4 is minus 11, plus I have received 10. So that means minus 11 plus 10 minus 1 is what I have invested in this time. Start solving it, putting it in the table and finding the payoff, and then we will draw the graph. Okay, so to start with the payoff, we start with the S0. The prices given are 55, 70, 80 and 95. So you bought a call option at 60. So you bought a call option with exercise price of rupees 60. So you have to decide whether you will exercise the option or no. And for a call option, we do S0 minus E. If we get the gain, we exercise the option. So 55 minus 60, we have a loss of minus 5. We will lapse this option. 70 minus 60, there's a gain of 10 rupees. We'll exercise this option. 80 minus 60, there's a gain of 20 rupees. We'll again exercise this option. 95 minus 60, there's a gain of 35 rupees, so we will again exercise the option. Okay, so now let's see with the third option. This also we have bought, so we will decide we'll exercise or no. So S0 minus E, 55 minus 90, I have a loss. So 90, there's a loss of minus 10 lakhs. 95 minus 90, there's a gain of 5. So I'll exercise this particular option. Now this is the option sold. So supposingly I have sold it to one of you. So let's assume that I have sold it to Vithal. Okay. So here, so Vithal will decide whether he will buy or no. And I will decide whether I will sell or no. I will have to oblige with whatever Vithal decides. So I have to sell it if he wants to buy. I don't have a right to decide. He has the right to decide. So Vithal will also do S0 minus E. 55 minus 75, he has a loss. It's better to buy for 55 in the open market than buying it from me for 75. So he will lapse the option. If he lapses the option, 0. 70 minus 75, for Vithal still 70. The market price is cheaper. So he will again lapse the option. 80 minus 75, now Vithal is gaining 5 rupees because buying at 75 will save him 5 rupees. His gain will be my loss. This is my account, so I will write minus 5 here. And 95 minus 75, Vithal will again gain 20 rupees. So this is my loss. Now here I have two options. Minus 2 into 20. Minus 40. So here I lose 10 rupees, two options, 5 rupees each. And here I lose 40 rupees, two options, 20 rupees each. So let's see the gross payoff. First case it will be 0. In the second case, 10 plus 0 plus 0 is 10. Plus 20 minus 10 is 10. Plus 35 minus 40 plus 5. So that is 40 minus 40. That comes to 0 again. Now the premium that we have paid is minus 1, 0, minus 1, 10 minus 9, and 0 minus 1 is minus 1. So this is how it will look like. Now we'll put it in the graph. Okay, so at 55 we have a loss of minus 1. At 70 we have a gain of 9. At 80 we have a gain of 9 again. At 95 we have a loss of minus 1. If you could just see here, there's nothing, there's no point here. But the butterfly spread should be in the. So if I don't join that, it would have, which is not a butterfly spread. In a cone shape only, any price in between these two, 70 and 80, any price here would have gone to the peak. This is not the peak. You are not gaining only 9. You could have gained even more than 9. Now here, the gap is too high, 55, 70, 80, 85. That's the reason you are not able to get that peak. If they would have taken 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 55 interval, then maybe you could have got it. So I can't join these two because butterfly spread looks like a peak. That's why I've just drawn the peak. and here you see, extend these lines, so it looks like a butterfly spread. So this was the problem on butterfly spread. I hope it's clear. Today we will start with combination. So we are done with the spread. We had three things in the spread: the bull spread, the bear spread, and the butterfly spread. So we have done sums on all the three types. So today we'll start with combinations. So under combinations, we have straddle, we have strip, strap, and strangle. So in these four, we have to do sums. There are many other strategies like collars, and there are one or two more, which I'm not dealing with in detail because they're not that popular as these are. So in combinations, we'll do only these four. So let me start with straddle today. Okay, under straddle, we'll understand first what is the straddle strategy. You have long straddle and you have short straddle. Under long straddle, you buy a call and you buy a put. So I buy. So under straddle, there's a long straddle and a short straddle. Long means buy, short means sell. So here you buy a call, you buy a put. Both have the same exercise price. So there is no need to worry at a higher price, at a lower price, which one to buy, which one to sell. Both you're buying and both have the same exercise price with the same expiry date. Whereas in case of a short straddle, you sell both. You sell one call, you sell one put with the same exercise price and the same expiry date. So let's do one problem. I'm doing one each. I'll do one for long straddle and I'll do one for short straddle. It's not that difficult. That's the reason I'm doing one sum so that just you could understand the strategy. Call options on a stock with an exercise price of rupees 70 is available for rupees 6. Okay, so there's a call option. This is available with the exercise price of rupees 70. And it is available for rupees 6. That means the premium is 6 rupees. While the put option on the same stock with the same expiration date and exercise price is selling for rupees 8. So this is call premium. And then you have put premium. 8 rupees. Then put exercise price. Same exercise price for both. Using the options, create a long straddle, draw the payoff table and graph. So they are asking you to create a long straddle. Okay, so first we'll see the premium, what happens to it. Okay, you buy a call, so you're going to pay premium minus 6. You buy a put, you're going to pay premium 8 rupees, so minus 6 and minus 8. So total premium that you will pay is 14 rupees. Minus 14 is the initial investment in the strategy. Now let's draw the payoff table for it. They should give you the spot prices, so the S0, I'll take it for you. So we have 55 to 90, so I'll take it here. Okay, you have bought the call option. How you calculate? You do S0 minus E. So 55 minus 70, you get a negative answer, so you lapse it. 60 minus 70, you get minus 10, so you again lapse it. Minus 70, you get minus 5, you lapse it. 70 minus 70, you anyways get 0. Now on, you will exercise it. 75 minus 70, your gain is 5 rupees. 80 minus 70, your gain is 10 rupees. 85 minus 70 again is 15 rupees and 90 minus 70 again is 20 rupees. Now this is a put option. You have bought the put option, and for put option we do E minus S0. So I'll do E minus S0. So 70 minus 55, I gain how much? 15 rupees. 70 minus 60, I gain 10 rupees. 70 minus 65, I gain 5 rupees. 70 minus 70 is 0. 70 minus 75 minus 5. So I will not exercise this option. I will lapse it. Because everything that you do, 75 minus 80 is minus 10. You'll go and lapse it. So it gets lapsed. Now just observe. If the call option is getting lapsed, the put option is getting exercised and you gain. If the call option is getting exercised, put is getting lapsed and you gain in the call. So if call option is good, put you will lose, but in call you will gain. If the put is good, in call you will lose, but in the put you will gain. So either of it, in whatever market conditions, either of it will give you some or the other gain. Now the gross payoff, 0 plus 15. In the initial stage only you invested 14 rupees, so 14 rupees premium you are paying. Minus 9. जीरो माइनस नाइन, सिक्सटीन माइनस वन एंड ट्वेंटी. सो दीज आर योर गेन्स. नाउ वी कैन पुट इट इन द पे ऑफ ग्राफ. सो आई विल ड्रॉ द ग्राफ दिस साइड फॉर यू. So your gain is up to 9 rupees. Sorry, your gain is 6 rupees maximum and loss is 9 rupees maximum. So we can take 5, 10 as the values. -5 and then you take your 55, 75, 80, 89. So these are the prices. From 55 to 90, and my 5 and 10 are the gains, minus 5 and minus 10 are the losses. So let's just try. At 55, you gain 1 rupee. So at 55, here. Then at 60, you lose 4 rupees. So at 60, I'm losing minus 4. At 65, you lose 9 rupees. So at 65, I'm at minus 9. Then at 70, you again lose 4 rupees, so at 4, just a second, sorry, at 70, you lose 14 rupees, not 4, it is 0 minus 14, 14 rupees, sorry for that. So at 17, you go minus 16 here, at 17, you lose 14 rupees, somewhere here. Then at 75, you lose minus 9 again. At 80, you lose 4 rupees. And then at 85, you gain 1 rupee. And then at 90, you gain 6 rupees. So, yeah. You can see the bottom straddle. It is also called as bottom straddle because the graph comes in the bottom. Your loss is the maximum loss that you lose is the premium amount, 14 rupees, not beyond that. So it's a bottom straddle. And why that has come as loss? Because we bought both the options, you have to pay a premium of 14 rupees. So even if you lapse, you will lose your 14 rupees premium. So the graph of a long straddle will be always in the negative thing. So we also call it as a bottom straddle. Okay, so this is also, I'll write it here. This is also top straddle or short straddle and long straddle or bottom straddle. Now this was about the long straddle. For the same sum, now we will do the short straddle and then I'll go to strip, strap and strangle. So the same data, I'm just doing a problem on short straddle. So instead of bought, now and here it will be plus. You sell a call, you receive premium. You sell a put, you receive premium. So plus 14 is your premium. So you have sold a call. So suppose I have sold this call to Amol. So Amol will decide S0 minus E, 70 minus 55. Amol will exercise the option. He will gain, sorry, S0 minus E, not E minus S0. So 55 minus 70, Amol will lapse the option. So even I am lapsing it. 60 minus 70 minus 10, Amol will not exercise, he will lapse. 65 minus 70, again Amol will lapse. And 70 minus 70 is 0. Now here, 75 minus 70, Amol will exercise the option. He will gain 5 rupees. But this is my account. His gain will be my loss. So I'll write minus 5 here. Okay. Then 80 minus 70, Amol will gain 10 rupees. It's my loss. So I'll write minus 10. minus 15 and 90 minus 20 minus 20. I'm losing this much. Okay, now suppose I've sold this put option. I've sold it to Varun. So Varun will decide now whether he wants to exercise or no. So for put option, he'll do E minus S naught. E is 70. S naught is 55. So 70 minus 55, Varun will gain 15 rupees, which is my loss. In his account, he will gain. This is my account. So I'll write a loss minus 15. 70 minus 60, Varun will gain 10 rupees, but I will lose 10 rupees. 70 minus 65, Varun will gain 5, my loss is 5. 70 minus 70 is 0. And after that, Varun will lapse all the accounts, because for him it is loss, he doesn't want to exercise. If he lapses, it will be lapse for me also, so it will be 0 after that price. So this is how all the options are lapsed. Now if you put it in the gross payoff, this side, 0. So here, minus 15 plus 14, you get minus 1. Is 4, minus 15 plus is minus 1, and minus 20 plus, put it in the graph now, and now I'll get a top straddle. Okay, so at 55 I have a loss of minus. At 60, I gain 4 rupees. Okay, then at 65, I gain 9 rupees. At 70, I gain full. At 85, it's again minus 1. And at 90, it's minus 6. So if you draw it, you get a top straddle. 14 rupees is the maximum gain that you will have. If you have sold both the call and the put option, the premium amount, that's 14 rupees, is what you will gain maximum. And below that, you can gain 9 rupees, 4 rupees, and your loss will not be more than 1 rupee. So you will lose only 1 rupee. Sorry, your loss can be also more. So you may lose even 6 rupees. Here we have minus 6. So as the prices go on increasing, your loss also can increase. But your gain will be maximum 14 rupees. So you have fixed your gain, the maximum gain as 14. Below that also you can gain, but you cannot go beyond 14. So this was about straddle, the long and the short straddle, or it is also known as the bottom and the top straddle. Okay, now we'll go to the next strategy, that is strip and strut. So we'll start with strip and strap. Same exercise price. That is, you sell one call and you sell two. Okay, so what happens here? You buy one call and you buy two puts with the same exercise price and same expiry in strip. And in strap, you sell one call, you buy two calls and you buy one put. So here you buy one call, buy two puts. Here you buy two calls, you buy one put. Same exercise price, same expiry date. So in both the cases, you're buying, you're not selling. So it's both will have a bottom diagram. We'll see how it will work out. Let's solve one sum on this. Okay, so I'll take a problem on strip. An investor buys a combination of two puts and one call. So he is buying two puts and one call with exercise price of rupees 60. For both, the exercise price is 60. Assume the call option cost 5 rupees and put option cost 6 rupees. So call premium 5 rupees and put premium 6 rupees. Identify the strategy involved and draw the payoff table and graph. So here you're buying 2 puts and 1 call. So the strategy is strip. And when you buy, you pay premium. The premium that you have paid is minus 11. Okay, the prices that they are asking you to use is S0 50, 55, 60, 65. We are going to use these prices and solve the problem. So let me take the prices here. So what we are doing, we are buying one call and we are buying two puts. So call, you buy. Okay, and the price is given is from 50 to 80. So from 50 to 80, I have taken the prices. Now you have bought the call and bought the put. So you can decide. For a call, we decide by doing S0 minus E. And for a put, we decide by doing E minus S0. So I'm doing call first. S0 minus E, 50 minus 60, I get minus 10. I will lapse this option. 55 minus 60, minus 5, I'll lapse the option. 60 minus 60 is 0. 65 minus 60, I'll gain 5 rupees. I'll exercise the option. So 80 minus 60, I gain 20 rupees. I have bought the option, so the gains are mine. This is my account and I am the owner who is deciding right to buy. I have not sold, I have bought them. Okay. Here, put options also, you buy two put options. So for put option, we do E minus S0. So 60 minus 50, you gain 10 rupees. There are two options. So 2 into 10, your gain is 20 rupees. Then 60 minus 55, one option gain is 5 rupees. 2 into 5, the total gain is minus 60 is 0. 60 minus 65 is minus 5. You will lapse the option, so it will be 0. 60 minus 70, loss of 10, you will lapse the option, and so on till 80, you will lapse the option. Gross payoff will be you have paid a premium of 11 rupees, so premium is minus 11. Minus 11 is this one, 15 minus 11 and 20. So this is how it's the gain. Ten minus 11 1. Okay, so we'll put it in the graph. So at 50 you gain 9 rupees. Then at 55 you lose 1. At 60 you lose 11 rupees. At 65 you lose 6 rupees. At 70 you lose 1 rupee again. At 75 you gain 4 rupees. And for 80 you again gain 9 rupees. Okay, so this is how the graph will look. You'll get a bottom graph. Reason being, you have bought both the options, you're paying premium, so maximum that you will lose is 11 rupees, which is your premium amount, not beyond that. Okay, so you have limited your losses to 11 rupees, you're not going to lose beyond that. So this was strip strategy. This strategy was strip. Okay, now let's go ahead and do the strategy trap. In case of trap, what we do, we buy two call, we buy one put with the same exercise price and same expiry date. So I'll take a problem up. An investor finds a call option on stock with an exercise price of rupees 60. So exercise price is 60. At a premium of rupees 7, so call premium is 7, and the put option on the same stock with an exercise price, with the same exercise price, and the premium is 10 rupees in this case. He believes that by buying the options, the prices will move either way. An upward price jump is likely to be more significant. What strategy? So he is going to buy both the options. And how he is going to buy? He is going to buy two call options. And buy one. So he'll buy two call and he'll buy one put. What are the prices given? We'll see. Okay, we'll take the same prices maybe. Start from $35 onwards, the prices. We'll take the prices from 35 to 75, and now we have bought, so we have to pay premium. Just a second, okay, guys. In the previous sum, just give me a minute. Two times you paid 6 rupees, right? So this is 2 into 6. 12 plus 5, 17 rupees. I'm sorry, we had to take 2, right? Because we bought 2 put options and we bought 1 call option in the previous sum. So that's minus 17 here. I'm correcting it, guys. See here. And if I minus it, 20 minus 17, I'm getting 10 minus. And 20 minus 17. So the graph won't be. I have to go up to 17 in the losses. Okay. So at 50, I have a loss. I have a gain of 3. At 55, I have a loss of 7 rupees. Okay. Then at 60, I have a loss of 17 rupees. So I'll come somewhere here. Then at 65, I have a loss of 12 rupees. At 70, I have a loss of 7 rupees again. At 75, I have a loss of 2 rupees. And at 80, I have a gain of 3 rupees. So this is how. Okay, I'm sorry, correct the problem. Your premium was minus 17. You bought 2 put options. So 2 into 6, 12 rupees you will pay. So all other things are correct. Only premium amount, if you change, your net payoff will change, because from the gross you will minus 17 rupees now, and the graph will change. So your maximum loss is 17 rupees. That's the premium amount that you pay. Okay, now let's do the strap strategy. In case of strap, what you have done, you have bought 2 call options and the call premium is 7 rupees. So 2 into 7. Minus 14, minus 10, minus 24 is your investment. Okay, so you have bought 2. When you buy 2 call options, you do S0 minus E. So 60 minus 35, you're gaining 25 rupees, right? 60 minus 35, 40, 50, 60. So 25 rupees you gain. two times, so 2 into 25, your gain is 50 rupees. Sixty minus 40, you will gain 20 rupees. 2 into 20, so your gain is 40 rupees. I'm sorry, something wrong today. For a call option, we do S naught minus E. So I have to do 35 minus 60. If I do 35 minus 60, I'm losing 25 rupees. So I'll lapse the option. I'll not exercise it. 40 minus 60, the loss is minus 20. So I will lapse the option. 45 minus 60, I'll lapse the option. 50 minus 60, I'll again lapse the option. I have a loss of minus 10. 55 minus 60, lapse. 60 minus 60, I'll lapse. 65 minus 60, I'm gaining 5 rupees. Two options, so 2 into 5 will be 10. Minus 60, I'm gaining 10 rupees. So 2 into 10, 20 I'll gain. 75 minus 60, I'm gaining 15 rupees. So 2 into 15, 30 rupees. Let's do put option now. I bought one put option, so the exercise price is 60. Exercise E minus S naught, 60 minus 35. Now I'm gaining 25 rupees. One option, so only once. 60 minus 40, I'm gaining 20 rupees. So these are the gains. Now we'll see the gross payoff. Sorry. -24 is -9. 10 minus 20 is 14. 5 minus 24 is -19. 0 minus 24. Minus 24, minus 14, 20 minus 24, minus 4, and 30 minus 6. So at 35, I lose 1 rupee. At 40, I lose 4 rupees. At 45, I lose 9 rupees. At 50, I lose 14 rupees. At 55, I lose 19 rupees. At 60, I lose again 14 rupees. Sorry, at 60 I lose 24 rupees, still down. At 65 I lose 14 rupees. At 70 I lose 4 rupees. And and at 75 I gained 60. So this is how the graph will look. So this was strap strategy. Okay. We'll continue with strangle in tomorrow's class and combinations. We did straddle, strip and strap. The only strategy left is strangle now, in which you have long strangle and short strangle. We'll do that in the next session along with the case study problems of options, how the cases would come and how we need to actually solve them. So there are around two problems of that same type, and we can also try to do one sum on if dividend is given, how to solve using Black-Scholes model. So we'll do that in the next class. Thank you.